David, both Quebec and Ontario have imposed new restrictions, if you will, as we get into the second wave of the pandemic when it comes to bars and restaurants. How bad is it for the food service industry now?
Well, it's really bad. And one of the reasons it's bad is because, you know, being the second wave, it's the second time over that restaurants, especially dining in, has to be closed. So just to give you an idea, you know, it could represent up to 33,000 jobs losses for Toronto only. And when we talk about, you know, loss of sales for regions that are in the red zones in Quebec and also some places in Ontario, you talk about 80%, so $4 out of $5 spent in full service restaurants that is gone. And even up to 40% loss of sales in the quick service, because even though they can continue with delivery and takeout, there's a lot of losses because people cannot dine in anymore.
Statistics Canada recently reported that 29% of restaurants cannot operate with social distancing measures, and 31% won't make it until December. What is your data telling you?
Well, I would say these figures from Statistics Canada are pretty aligned with our own survey and our own, you know, data that we get from the industry that, you know, since the beginning of the crisis, especially for independent and family restaurants, 10% are closed there and gone forever. And you still have 44% that are operating, you know, at a loss. And of those, 72% think that they're not going to be able to make it if nothing significant happened over the next 12 months. So it's going to take at least 12 months for those 72% that are operating at a loss to come back to profitability. And this is not expecting, you know, a third wave or other complications due to distancing. So, of course, very, very difficult environment right now for restaurants.
What are you hearing from these restaurants who have taken on additional costs with respect to trying to keep their staff protected, customers that may come in for pickup protected? What have been these, this additional weight that's been put on these restaurants? What are you hearing?
Well, we're hearing that it is a big burden to shoulder, but, you know, there was a lot of hope last spring that restaurants could reopen in the summer and start doing some business again with the patios, even if you have some social distancing measure that you could operate. But the second wave of closing is really, you know, a hit in the knees for restaurateurs, especially as, you know, both in Ontario and Quebec, I think we've not seen, you know, written explanation from the public health authorities into why are restaurants reclosing and why other sectors of the economy are able to remain open and able to continue to do what they do. So it is something that we've asked, because it is a lot to ask of restaurants to reclose after you ask them to invest and put a lot of money into making people safe. And honestly, food service was not a big place where you've seen a lot of, you know, these COVID cases and those kind of things. So there's a lot of question, especially for dining restaurants.
Quebec recently introduced a support program of about $15,000 for each business. The federal government has its own support programs. Do they need to be revamped, or is it enough?
It's interesting that you bring this up, because Restaurants Canada has been at the table with the Quebec government to work on this program and to make sure that it can be put in place. Understanding, you know, a government support can never replace the possibility to be open and to run your regular business. And at the federal level, I think one thing that we're looking for is that a program for rent and support for fixed costs that is not mutually exclusive to whatever provincial programs are put in place. Definitely looking for something that would make tenants eligible, even if they're, you know, if their landlords don't want to participate in the program, just to make sure that operators and restaurants can benefit from this rent support. Encouraging sign both from Minister Freeland and the Prime Minister over the last few weeks, but we're still awaiting the details. They told us that there's a program that is coming that's going to replace the old rent program. It's going to be retroactive to October 1st or September 27th, but we're still awaiting for the details. And it always makes us a little bit nervous when the details takes time to come, because then we wonder if the program is going to be as good as advertised.
Now, you had mentioned something with respect to the second wave, and now patios and restaurants that were serving on these makeshift patios, if you will. We're now getting into this cooler weather. What is the major concern?
Well, the major concern is exactly what you said, the cold and the weather. Over the weekend here in the Ottawa region, I went to a breakfast place and I had, you know, my blanket around me and those kind of things. It was very nice to be able to eat outside, but at the same time, is it something that is viable going into November and December? I don't know. Some places will install those ethers and those kind of things, but they're not going to be able to generate enough volume to remain sustainable for a long time under these conditions. The things that need to happen, honestly, is for the sanitary situation to improve and for the restaurants to be able to reopen. And in the meantime, for both provincial and federal program to be able to carry restaurants and food service establishment through this, understanding that it's not going to be possible to save everybody, but there needs to be things in place to give hope and for operators to say, okay, I'm going to take a loss. It's going to be hard for a few months, but I want to remain in business. And this is the problem we have right now. It's very hard to maintain hope of people because it's a second wave and it's still the same answer. Closures, closures, and closures.